You know who I think is going to really struggle?
Bit is late, Penny. Bit late, Shari.
Sure. But Penny Wong will really struggle, because already there was this schism opening up between Australia and the United States on various policy issues, Israel being one of them. You saw that with our United Nations vote. And that was under a Biden administration. Under a Trump administration, you've got climate change, you've got the Middle East, you've got so many other issues. China, for one, where the US is going to be a lot more forward-leaning. And, you know, how's Penny Wong going to handle that? She will be truly devastated tonight, which quite delights me. Richo, what do you think about that?
Yeah, I think it wouldn't be Penny's best night, that's for sure. But I think Trump worries me in one sense. He's always been an isolationist. America first, second, third, fourth, etc. He's always had that view. And I just hope that view is moderated considerably in this term of his presidency, because we need America to not be isolationist. We need it to lead the world. We need it to try and stand up against an ever more confident China. So as far as I'm concerned, there are some really good points about Trump getting up. I can think of a few that aren't so good, but let's look on the bright side.
What do you think about that point, Michael Kroger? You know, the isolationist leanings, which, by the way, J.D. Vance, you know, has worrying signs of. I think there are other very strong Republican figures who set the tone for foreign policy in the last administration. Mike Pence, Mike Pompeo, Michael McCaul, a lot of those figures who really made sure that America still was the leader of the free world when Trump was president in 2016.
Yeah, I do agree with Graham, though. I don't like his isolationist approach, best evidenced by his position on the Ukraine. I mean, what is he thinking? I mean, this is another civilizational battle. So, but look, you know, what do we know about Trump? He doesn't like wars. He likes American military power to be used decisively when it's used, which he used against the ISIS leader, which he used against ISIS back in 2019. I would expect him, as he has said, to get on the phone to Putin very soon and say this war's got to end. And I think he's going to put massive pressure on Iran. Mm-hmm. He knows that a solution in the Middle East can only happen. This whole notion of the two-state solution, peace in the Middle East, it can only happen when Iran are not funding the terrorist organisations in Gaza, on the West Bank and in Lebanon. Trump knows that. And so I think Iran are going to be under great pressure sooner rather than later. I think he's going to be a success on foreign policy. The Abraham Accords, which we've talked about before, were a brilliant step forward. And I think he will probably, more than any other president in the last 20 or 30 years, he more than anyone has a hope of bringing some kind of lasting peace to the Middle East.
Yeah. All right, let's hope you're right on that point. Michael Kroger, Graham Richardson, thank you for joining me tonight.